ALP Group is a 1,000 crore group as of now. It started in 1984, and we are a very creative and innovative company, having brought into India modern technologies way back in 1984. We are the first ones to bring EPDM into the country, and today every vehicle that you see on the road has EPDM sealing systems, and we are major suppliers to all the OEMs like Maruti, Honda, Toyota, Tata, Mahindras, and railways. Thereafter, we went on to develop a new product called elastomeric foam, which was a MNC technology. And we did all engineering and brought the product in 2006, competing with the world leaders. And with a recognized R&D by the government of India, we developed these products and are today the masters or the leaders in insulation, acoustics, and sound deadening products.
Today we would like to discuss about the new product Elastofoam. Before I go into the details, I would like to tell you that it is primarily used as a radiant barrier. Radiant barriers are used typically for warehouses and metallic roofs. Any radiant barrier is used to reflect the radiant heat. It reflects almost 95% of the heat and allows only 5% transmission.
Now, this is a unique product which has got good fire properties, good reflectivity, and is very conducive to the Indian environment.
It is different from the other traditional materials like a bubble foam or an cross-linked polyethylene by the fact that it gives us a better reduction in temperature and also helps us to reduce the noise. So we have made a model of a metallic roof. We are installing below the roof a layer of the bubble foam, and we will subject it to temperatures close to 80 degrees centigrade, and after that we will check the temperature inside the building or the inside the warehouse. A similar test will be done for elasto roof, and then we will compare the temperatures for both cases. Today we are going to test three different materials to find out the effect of the radiant barrier. We have in front of us the elasto roof, which is a product of ALP Aeroflex. Then we have another material, which is the bubble foam. It has aluminium foil on both sides and a bubble in between. And the third material we have is cross-linked polyethylene sheet with one side aluminium foil. Now we will test the effect of all these three different materials as a radiant barrier. To do so, we have simulated a warehouse on my left hand side, which has a metallic roof. Below the warehouse roof, you can see we have inserted the cross-linked polyethylene foam with the aluminium foil facing upwards. To create and simulate the temperatures of the sun, we have used a rheostat which is generating about 80 degrees centigrade through these filaments, and the radiant heat produced through these filaments are generating a temperature of roughly 54 degrees Celsius. With the help of another thermocouple, we can measure the temperature inside the warehouse. With the help of this yellow device, I will show you the two readings that we get after employing an XLP sheet. So you can see the temperature at the top of the roof is close to around 50 degrees centigrade, while the temperature inside the small warehouse is around 30 degrees centigrade. So there is a drop of roughly 20 degrees centigrade across this structure. Now we will perform the same experiment using a bubble foam. You can see that the temperature of the top surface of the roof is now maintained to closely 53 degrees centigrade, and the temperature inside the warehouse is roughly 31 degrees centigrade. So from this experiment, we are able to see that the temperature has dropped from 53 degrees to 31 degrees inside. So there is a drop of roughly 22 degrees centigrade by using the bubble foam. Now we will do the third experiment of testing the elasto roof which is a open cell nitrile foam along with a high reflective aluminium foil. Now you can see the temperature on the roof surface is now 54.2 degrees, while the temperature inside the warehouse is now 31.2, which means a 3 degree drop. I will show you through this thermocouple. After the sample testing of three different materials for the temperature drop across the metal roof, we find that Elasto Roof from ALP Aeroflex has performed the best. It has given you a temperature drop of 23 degrees across the sheet metal surface. Now we will do the fire testing of three different sample materials. The first material is the bubble foam, as you can see. Now we will fire test it for 30 seconds and you can see the reaction. As you can see from the fire test, that the bubble between the two aluminium sheets has melted and it has lost its integrity of thermal insulation. Now we will do the fire test for the second material, with this cross-linked polyethylene. Now you can see the effect of the fire on the polyethylene material. See, even now after removing the lighter, the flame is still burning continuously. This is a major drawback of the polyethylene. Now we'll do the third test for elastofoam, which is a nitrile rubber material which has an aluminium sheet on the top surface. So let us see the effect of fire burning for 30 seconds. As you can see, the material has quenched. There is self-extinguishing feature in the nitrile foam. The flame has stopped by itself after removing the lighter flame. Elastofoam is one of the best materials in terms of fire. It is self-quenching and does not allow the flame to spread. We as a company can provide entire solution for thermal and acoustic insulation.
And on we would be now developing more products, because we have selling operations in US, in Australia, in South Africa, in Spain, and we have had many opportunities to develop products for the American, European and the Australian market. And I see a very good future in the new technologies, innovative technologies that ALP is working on.